Hello and welcome everyone. This is Andrea Hess and today we're talking about the ultimate remedy for those of you who have trouble powerfully putting your message out into the world. As you know you should or could? Or has your email list not heard from you in months? Is writing a newsletter and creating a video on your to-do list, you know, every day, but you just don't get around to it? Or you start writing and then rewrite and then rewrite until you scrap it all and just start over? Marketing reluctance manifests itself in a gazillion different ways, from constant, endless, you know, researching on how to market yourself, tweaking and tweaking and tweaking again of copy, taking yet another class on, you know, the coolest new marketing techniques, installing the newest little plugin and technical gadget, or we spend our time creating classes and programs and products that only really exist on a notepad at home or in our heads. And we can stay extremely busy not marketing ourselves. There's a huge difference between planning to put your message out into the world and learning better and more effective ways to put your message out into the world and actually putting something, anything, out there where people might actually read or see it. The root cause of marketing reluctance is pretty simple. We're terrified. I mean, truly, truly fearful of what other people think. And you know, we can chant the words, what other people think of me is none of my business. You know, we can say that all day long. We've heard it before. But at the end of the day, no matter how much we tell ourselves that we shouldn't care, we are scared. We're scared to death that we're going to put our message out into the world and the world won't really care. Or worse, the world will think we have nothing valuable to say. Or that people will look at us and think, well, who the heck does she think she is? You know, what are her qualifications? Or what gives her the right to call herself an expert of any kind? So we react to this fear in one of two ways. Number one, we put a tiny, tiny, tiny amount of content out into the world. Maybe none at all. I know people who spend years trying to publish their website. Or maybe we spend, you know, 3 weeks creating and recreating a little 4-minute video, or it takes us a month to edit an article that we then consider worthy of publishing. So we have great ideas for what we want to write about in the shower, but then we sit down at the computer and our mind just goes blank. So we focus instead on our comfort zone of dreaming up valuable and amazing programs and products that just, they never actually make it out in front of an actual prospective client. We certainly don't create powerful marketing funnels that actually lead prospects into working with us. Now, the second reaction is inauthenticity, which usually leads to really, really bad marketing. I mean, we might ramble on and on about ourselves and our videos in this unconscious need to impress people with our fabulousness. We might imitate someone else's style of writing or editing video, or even their content. Or we edit ourselves within an inch of some weird notion that we have of perfection. But then we just erase our entire personality from our message in the process. So we show up as boring. Or worse, we develop some weird public persona, sort of an alter ego that just comes off as fake and weird. All of it looks disingenuous and plastic, and obviously it doesn't bring us clients. Now there's a really, really simple remedy for all this. And that remedy is simply standing in service. I mean, sure, we say we're all about serving others and raising consciousness on our planet, but when we're not powerfully putting our work out into the world, what are we really about? We're all about our own little ego's need to be safe, to avoid negative attention or criticism. I mean, God forbid someone thinks something bad about me. That's the ego talking. Or on the flip side, we're fulfilling our need to be liked. We try to impress people, to make others think how amazingly gifted and incredibly wise we are. When we're in marketing reluctance, we're all about me, me, me. The little me, the ego me. Am I good enough? What will people think of me? Will they like me? Will they think I suck? Will they think I'm awesome? Will they think, wow, she's so great? It's so self-centered. But if we're in the energy of service, well, there's just no room for self-consciousness, is there? There's no room for ego. When we're about truly helping others, we do not worry about how we're perceived. We don't care what people will think because how we're perceived is so completely, totally unimportant compared to the difference that we want to make in the world. When we're focused on service, we don't worry about little spelling mistakes or, you know, how our hair looks on video. We don't feel mortified if we publish a newsletter with a broken or missing link or if we have technical mishaps because we're too busy serving people. Last week, I spent 2 days with a client creating a video marketing funnel, and it was a huge project. And it was so beautiful to witness her letting go of self-consciousness and any need to manage people's perception, because serving others through her message was far more important to her. So she got over being uncomfortable on video. She got over perfectionism, and the end result, it was not perfect. It was better than perfect because it was warm and genuine and it came from the heart and it was absolutely beautiful to watch. So just remember, if you're reluctant to put yourself out there, if you're constantly editing yourself or revising yourself, if you're trying to create a perception, you're being all about you. And the way to get over all that is to serve. Remember, no one can be served by you unless they actually know you exist and know what you're about. So get out there and change the world. And by the way, you might actually make more money while you do all that. This is Andrea Hess. Thank you so much for watching.